Question two.
My question is, how much weightage will be given to the experience, number of years of experience you have? I have 2+ years experience. My resume, I mean, my application will be a competitor of someone who is having 15+ experience. So in that case, so what all things they will look in a profile?
Okay.
Which is having less.
Before even I go to the panel, I'm going to take a dig at this, right, with your permission. See, first of all, here is the deal. You have a target list of B schools. All of them publish what is the average years of experience. So you exactly know what kind of profile you're trying to get yourself inducted into. Simple. ISB has like what? Five and a half years. Right? If you're applying as a 2 year or 2+ year or 3 year experience, you better well, you know that you are on the other side of the spectrum. Which means you need to be someone who has done something extraordinary. It's not that something that everybody does. In my batch, there are at least five people who are with just 2 to 3 years experience, but all of them had done something different. One of them was in the strategy group, handling big projects. One of them was a statistician who was doing something very crazy, what no normal kid would do, right? So basically, there's some different story to sell their reduction. Because end of the day, as I said, what is the thing that we derive from all these B schools? What are we getting inducted into B schools for? For the people that we interact with. Now, what is their benefit in taking someone who is below the average years of experience of their intake? Because their belief is they bring in their experiences from whichever industry they are from, and they battle out that together. So for you, even before saying that, okay, I have 2.5, what should I do? First is to figure out a target list to see if you're in the average, you're above average, you're below average. But considering you're 2.5 or like somewhere there, I would assume that you're below average, which means what is your selling point? That is the plain question. Even if I'm sitting in the ADCOM committee, first question I ask you, you have done 2.5 years of experience in this particular company. What is your selling point? How would you add value to the people who come here to this class? That is my first question. If you do not have a convincing answer, that is exactly where it ends. But then I would like to take additional views.
I have more than 10 years experience. The factor that I think many ADCOMs will consider is whatever your experience be, as he said, what is the quality of that experience? Is it what you have done in that, say, 5 or 6 or 10 years or maybe even 2 years, which highlights or which makes it different from somebody else, right? So how you can put your story in a way and with instances from your experience, professional experience, as well as maybe the other outside experience or co-curricular activities as well, how you can frame that story in a way that which will differentiate you from somebody else. So if you can find that storyline, then it doesn't matter actually. Fair. For me, there were a lot of things for my 10 years of experience which I had to pick and choose and say that, okay, this makes me stand out.
How many of us have the luxury, like a buffet of things to do? You know, you've done all your life and then you have to choose.
It's not so easy. That's why it took around 2 months to put my application.
Sure. Yeah.
So a good thing that he covered was the qualitative aspect of it.
Mm-hmm.
Now let's think of it as a quantitative, right? Imagine each and every part of your profile to be a check plus or a check minus, right? Or a neutral thing.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if you're applying to a college where average GMAT is around 710 and you have a 690, it's a check minus. Mm-hmm. So you have to minimize your check minuses. If you have check plus, possibly it may tilt your profile to, you know, acceptance. But as much as possible, as he said, do the research, be in the median. If you're above the median, it's great, right? So try to have the minimum check minuses. That's the one thing I'll tell you, because GMAT is the gating factor, and that is where most of the people, you know, get rejected.
Right.
So try to have that as good. Try to have the education qualification. You cannot really do much thing about it, because what has happened has happened, but you can really work on the experience. That's the thing.
He talked about check minus. So I have 2 check minuses. So first one was I had a GMAT of 700 and ISB average is 710 or 711. So that was one check minus.
Very little.
Second check minus was that ISB's average work ethic is 5 years.
Yeah.
I have less than 2 years. So that was check minus minus. So so
still your IT thing is kicking in, man. Come on.
So but the overall process is same. So if you have enough stories to tell them, and moreover those stories are aligned to your goals, and they are able to understand that whatever stories you are telling and their impact is aligned that what you want to do in the future, they're very open to it, and if they have taken you, they can take you also if your story is convincing. Thank you.
And for people with lesser experience, their educational recommendation also matters. So you can try to get a recommendation from your professor which could highlight what you have done in your college. So that's
excellent. I just heard in the background, since you mentioned that you are sub 2 years and you made it to ISP, what is your story?
Okay. I am working at Samsung as at Samsung Research, but I would not say that added to the diversity what I wrote in my essays. Actually, I was the finalist of a global business plan competition in 2013. I think that was one of the factors. Other two factors are I was working on few startup ideas on my own.
Okay.
Some didn't work. One didn't work, and one I was working that I closed couple of months back.
Sure.
So I think these two things added to the diversity. And the one question that the ADCOM question that I asked that was that if you're so much into technology, why don't you go for MS?
Sure.
So why do you want to come to ISB and do an MBA? If you're developing technology products, go for an MS. So you have to be prepared for that. I am not going to tell my answer because that will create a bias. So I will say that.
Excellent. All right. Here's one thing before even I open the floor to the questions.